Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Westby, Ken Manning, Western Wisconsin Video Productions, as we are set to bring you tonight's Junior Legion and Senior Legion baseball game. It's going to be a doubleheader of sorts, just that it's juniors and then the seniors. The first pitch is going to be in there. It's a swing and a miss. This ball game underway as we bring you the game from Veterans Memorial Field here in downtown Westby. Lights are coming on. It's a little bit overcast. And we're going to do everything we can to make sure that there's no rain tonight. How about that? Well, thanks to all the wonderful sponsors as we get things going. There's another swing and a miss. The count now 1-2 for Griffin Nelson, who is doing the pitching here for the Westby Coon Valley Bandits as they take on the junior 138ers. That's going to one hop on the right side of Anders Hoven, who is Nelson's battery mate. It's Lynn Thiebold and Ryan Kowalski, your first three hitters here for Viroqua. Here's a ground ball. Nice pick by the shortstop. A long throw, and they're going to just get him. Great hustle over there by Lind, but it's going to be a 6-3 put out. And there's one down. Here's Finn stepping in from the right-hand side. Swing and a miss for Thiebold. Nelson jumps out ahead, 0-1. Now it's 0-2 on the swing and miss. That one low and away. Had Thiebold going after it. Here's a fly ball. This one could be trouble. It's going to be in there for a base hit. Hung that one over the plate a little bit too much in one sense, and Thiebold was able to put it out in right center field. And it's the first base hit of the ball game here. That's going to bring up Ryan Kowalczyk, the catcher. Ryan stepping in again, right-handed batter. Here's a ground ball. This is back up the middle. That's going to be a base hit. Thiebold will hold at second base as charging in center field was Chase Qualhorst. Now the pitcher in Alex Klum with two on and one down. Klum will look to try and get his cause going right away with another base hit. Thanks to Sealand's Carpetland helping us out today as that pitch is going to be low and away for ball one. Nelson with a peek and now fires in. It's going to be a ground ball. That's going to get through for a base hit, and they're going to hold the runner down here at third base. Right fielder coming in quickly here in Hadley Brown. But three hits in a row here now, and the 138ers have something cooking right away. Here's a swing and a miss on the opening offering here to number five hitter in Tanner Bast. There's going to be a strike. Here's a ground ball. They'll go to second base for one. The relay is not going to be in time. And a run will score. They'll get the runner heading to second base in Clum. That was a 6-4 put out. That's out number two. Now fielder's choice there for Bast. Thiebold scores. Kowalczyk down at third. And in steps Peterson. And he's going to lace one right back up the middle for a base hit. They'll get the runner across here in Kowalczyk. Boy, a number of hits coming up here for the Viroqua squad. Three hits in a row. And four out of five. There's a call and strike for Hoyum. Here's the next offering. That's going to be up on the shoulder region for a ball. And the count goes to 1-1. A swing and a foul ball. That one coming right back to the wall here. You might have heard the clunk in the background. One to the count now. The 138ers with a couple of crossed already here looking for more. Swing and a miss. That will take care of the inning as Peterson goes down swinging. But let's take a quick look here. Two runs on four hits and a couple runners left on base. We're going to take a little break and we'll come right back with more action here from Westby. Get things started up here as the Westby Coon Valley Bandits now trailing 2-0. And their top of the order, it's Griffin Nelson, Maddox Fensel, and Everett Hoven. Here's the first pitch. It's going to be a ground ball, third base side, a long throw, and he's going to get on. I almost think he had it beat out anyways. He's going to head down to second base. Well, I tell you what, I'm Very, very tempted to give him the base hit on that.
Next up, number 9, Maddox Fensel.
So one on. Here is Maddox Fensel. Fensel, a right-handed hitter. Shortstop today with Everett Hoven due up next. The first offering from Alex Klum is in there for a called strike. That's going to bring in, and also I should mention the battery mate here in Ryan Qualchek. Now 1-1. Again, our sponsors, we do kind of the quick hitter with them tonight. It's Sleepy Hollow helping us out on the north side of Viroqua and Vernon Electric Cooperative right here. Just outside Westby, Highway 27, just off Highway 27. Appreciate all of our fine folks and their wonderful support. 2-1 now as Klum takes a look and comes in with a pretty good fastball, and it's fouled back. Two and two now. That offering is way up over the head of Fensel. And that'll bring up a full count. Klum into the stretch. A fastball that's upstairs for a ball. So now two on. A base hit and a walk. And it brings up your number 3 hitter in Everett Hoven. Left-handed hitter. Takes a cut at the first offering that was in there on the knees. Also a great thank you to the VFW of Viroqua for their support today. Here's a runner taking off for third, the slide in. Excuse me, and he's going to be in there. Got a good jump on the ball, did Nelson. Now runners at first and third for the Bandits. That'll be high, moving away from the hitter here with Hoven. Two and two now. And that's going to be just outside for a ball. It's now loaded up. 3-2 now. Klum is set, runner taking off, and that ball's going to get away, and coming down the line, it's going to be a run scored here. Hoven with the walk. Fensel down to second base, and Griffin Nelson is in for the score. The first offering is downstairs. Swing and a miss. Jeremy Hayes is the EH today, the extra hitter. The Bandits going with 10. 10 hitters today. That one's chopped foul. One, two, the count to the EH. A little bit high, now two and two. Here's a shot out to left field. It's going to be right at the left fielder here. Played that one pretty well, did Jaden Burkhart. And there's one down.
Number five, Chase.
Hayes with a good line drive, but again, Burkhart all ready for that one. Here's Chase Quellhorst now with one down and two on base. Looking to try and move the runner in Fensel down at second, who's in scoring position. Here's a ball lifted up high. Coming up is the center fielder to make the grab. Out there in center field. Let's take a look here. That's Tyden Lind. Yeah, he had kind of an easy one. He just kind of looped along there, didn't he? Making that grab, and now there's two down. Here's Jaden Johnson. Johnson watches the first pitch. It's going to be a ball. Thanks to the Viroqua Booster Club helping us out today. And it's all Dr. Leanne Klum walking around here cheering on her son Alex, who's out there on the mound. That's Viroqua Dental Center bringing you today's game. 2-0 now. That ball pops away from Kowalczyk, and hustling down to third base was Fensel. Well, now Fensel 90 feet away from tying this ball game up. 2-1 your score. There's a strike. Got the automatic in there. Right down the middle. Now 3-1 with two on. That's going to be inside for a ball. Johnson with the walk, and that loads up the bases. Here's Micah Larson, who's playing third base today. Micah watches the first pitch downstairs. No place to put Larson, and there's a strike. He came right after him. Klum evens the count with that strike at one apiece, and it's just a bit inside, maybe a touch high. It's 2-1. That's upstairs. Now 3-1. Swing and a miss. A full count now to Micah Larson. Runners taken off, foul ball, and hung on by Kowalczyk, and a nice job there to get that third out on the strikeout. We'll take a little break and come back. One run coming across here on, let's take a look here, one hit, I believe. There were three walks in the inning, no errors, and three left on base. 2-1 your score. Okay, back we come here. We're checking on some volume issues, I guess. So I apologize for that. Hopefully we'll be able to get that stuff taken care of here a little bit, or now. Every once in a while, I get things just a tad off, whatever happens and however that happens. But thanks, Monty Bankus, kind of checking in on some things. We'll see how maybe that sounds. I made a little adjustments here. Keep my fingers crossed anyways, right? We'll take a look here. Swing and a miss. That is out number one, as that was Ben Hoyam up to bat here. So one away. And that is the second strikeout of the ball game here for Griffin Nelson. Oh, I guess I'm off one. This is Tyler Burris, excuse me. Or check that, Brandon Scrady. I'll get it right. So that was Burris that struck out? Okay, thank you. Here's a little chopper underneath going the other way. That's fouled back over the top of us. So it sounded like, anyways. And there's another strikeout. Back to the top of the order here now with Titan Lynn with two down. Two away, and Lynn, who had grounded out 6-3, stepping in, and his swing and a miss at the first offering. There's a strike. Nelson checked his swing. They're going to say no, he did not go around. Or Linda, should say, checked his swing. And that's fouled back. Not sure if that got the catcher or the umpire in Ben Urbanek. Maybe both, for that matter. One to the count. Here comes Nelson. Curveball got him in there for a called strike three, and Nelson took care of business himself here in the top of the second inning. An easy 1-2-3 inning for the Bandits. No runs, no hits, and nobody left on base. We'll be back with more here in a moment's time. We take a little break. Here we go with Anders Hoven now stepping in. Hovind is sitting at 3-0. And there's a called strike. Got the automatic in there. And there's ball four.
Now batting number 19, Hadley Brown.
Hovind with the walk. Hadley Brown steps in. He is hitting from the left side here. That ball is lifted foul. There's a called strike. Here goes the runner and the slide. He is going to be out of there. A great throw by Kowalczyk. One down, and Brown sitting with a 2-2 count. And there's called strike three. Just like that, two down. There's a swing and a miss. Maddox Torkelson is the left fielder. And a little foul ball at the left side. Just missed outside on that particular pitch. Now called strike three, and that will end the inning. A 1-2-3 inning there for the 138ers. Back and forth they go here. It's still a 2-1 ball game. The 138ers with the lead. We'll come back for the third inning. Finn Theobald steps into the batter's box here in the top of the third inning here on this Junior Legion ball game in a ball chop foul. Our thanks going out to the Vasatag Funeral Home helping us with today's broadcast. Of course, Westby and Viroqua. The Westby Co-op Creamery, I got to admit, I stopped in there for one of those ice cream cones. Tell you what, folks, that waffle one for $5, that's a pretty good deal. And the Westby Co-op Credit Union, we appreciate their terrific support. Well, it's 0-2 here to Finn Theobald. Michael Larson now pitching, and that's fouled off. He hung in there. Viroqua will play in the Junior Legion Regional at Prairie du Chien on Thursday. And a game against, I think it's the La Crosse A's. We were talking about that a little bit. Westby will play the winner of that game on Friday morning at 10 o'clock. That ball scoots away from Anders Hoven. And the count is 1-2. To the 138er, right fielder. There's a swing and a miss. He went after a high fastball, and there's one away.
Next batter, number 16, Ryan Kowalczyk.
Here's your number three hitter, the catcher, Ryan Kowalczyk. Kowalczyk from the right-hand side came up with a base hit. Second of, I think, four maybe in that inning. Go back through and take a peek there anyways. I think it was four hits, yeah. Because they went 1-2-3 in the second. Here's a shot center field going back, and will make the catch. Chase Quellhorst on his horse and was able to pull that one down on a big smash by Kowalczyk. Here's Alex Klum, the pitcher. Two down, Klum will look to try and jumpstart the offense here. Klum with the third base hit in a row. Back in that first inning, he fouls that one off. Right back at people. Larson is in a stretch, and his pitch is just a bit inside for a ball. 1-1. Here's a hopper back up the middle, and that's going to be a base hit. Tell you what, a well-placed swing right there. Get the base hit. His second of the ball game. That brings up Tanner Bast, who hit into a fielder's choice in the first. He too tried to go back up the middle, and that's where the shortstop came through in Fensel. Popped this one up and out of play. Right on top of the concession stand roof. And it's 0-1. This is a fly ball. Coming up is Quellhorst, and he'll make the grab for out number three. Well, no runs on one hit, and one runner left on. We'll take another little break here. We go to the bottom half of inning number three. It's 2-1 for Viroqua. Griffin Nelson is going to step in. Nelson from the right-hand side is the leadoff man. Klum, first pitch, it's going to be a bunt and trying to get down the line, and he's going to be just a bit shy. Oh, he might have turned an ankle on that one. I have to see here. I might have to take a moment here and help him a little bit as he hit that base. So we'll take a little break ourselves here and be right back. Back we come, and you probably saw in the during the timeout here with coaches helping Griffin across the field here as he jammed his foot on first base. So we'll hope everything is okay there. It winds up a 1-3 put out for out number one, trying to bunt his way on to a single. Not able to do that. Well, it's going to bring up, let's take a look here, number two hitter in Maddox Fensel. Fensel stepping in with one down, nobody on. And first pitch is going to be in there for a called strike. And now it's 0-2, just like that. Here's a ball hit right back up the middle. Fensel coming up with a big hit. Well, we saw that with the 138ers back in the first inning. It was down 0-2, and Thiebold put one right back up the middle. Now Fensel did it. Here's Everett Hovind now with a runner on and one down. Pretty good cut, came up empty there though. Thanks to Eagle Title Company in Coon Valley helping us out. That's gonna get away from Kowalczyk, and Fensel will be down to second base. One-one, now 2-1. Fensel scoots down to third, 90 feet away, on two back-to-back pass balls. Two-one, now the count. Swing and a miss. Now even at two apiece. Hovind with a walk back in the first inning and was left stranded at second base by the time Broco got three outs. That ball is fouled back. Two-two offering, it's a swing and a miss on a ball up on the shoulders, and there are two away here now. That's gonna bring up Jeremy Hayes. Let's take a look here for Klum. That is strikeout number three for him. That ball nearly got away. Good job by Kowalczyk getting to it. The next offering is down low on the shins for a ball. Two and oh now. missed a little bit low and away. Evinger's Equipment Sales and Service helping us out on the north side of Viroqua. And that's going to be inside, ran real tight on him for a ball. And Hayes trots down to first base with the walk. Fensel down at third. With two away, you got runners at first and third. And Chase Quellhorse is up to bat. Fouls the first pitch off. The offering is in there for a strike, just under the letters. Now 0-2. Curveball, that was a dandy. And that will finish off the inning here as Klum comes up with strikeout number 4. Yeah, let's take a look here. No runs on one hit. Two left on base with the walk included. And we're going to go to the top of the fourth inning. It is still a 2-1 game here with Viroqua leading. It's going to be Colton Peterson to lead things off here for the 138ers, the junior 138ers, I should say. Seniors coming up a little bit later here yet tonight in a twin bill of ball games. Viroqua traveling to Westby. Micah Larson is still on the mound. Two runs on five hits and air in the ball game. That's fouled off for Viroqua with the lead. One run on two hits, no errors for the Bandits of Westby Coon Valley. Again, that ball skips past Hoven. Two-one now. And that's low and away again. Couple of offerings in that direction. Thanks to Miles of Smiles Child Care Center over at Our Savior's Church, and of course, Nordic Lanes, Scott and Sue Sordahl helping us out. Here's a ball that's going to get through over here at first base. You do not see that very often. Everett Hoven went down to scoop that one out, and it just kind of like ate him up, I guess you'd say. First error of the ball game on the Bandits. Here's Ben Hoyam. Showing bunt, and he fouls it off on the first base side. Larson out in front, 0-1 here on the count. It looked like he wanted to go with another one, but that time the ball was downstairs. He let it go. That's a foul ball. trying to move the runner, and now he's in a predicament with a 1-2 count. Looking to probably swing away here. No, I think they said they saw some lightning. So we will have to take a break now. A break in the action, that means a half hour break here. With the lightning, it's play is suspended. So we'll be back in 30 minutes or so. Here we go with the restart after the half-hour delay. Boy, it felt like forever, didn't it? But we're ready to get things going here. Back again with a 1-2 count for Micah Larson, and that's going to be a foul ball. Stepping in is Ben Hoyam, number one. Again, it just sets things back a little bit here as well. Have the Senior Legion game following this. There's a called strike three as Michael Larson's going to get the punch out. I believe that is Larson's second strikeout of the ball game. The first couple of innings was Griffin Nelson. Here's a ball popped foul and just out of play. Runner down at first base is Colton Peterson. Thanks to the Riverbank helping us out today, Coon Valley and Westby. There's a called strike. Also, Premier Co-op located right here in Westby, bringing you the action. Larson's going to step off just for a moment here. Facing Tyler Burris. Burris struck out facing Nelson. That was in the second inning. In fact, Nelson was able to go 1-2-3 with all three strikeouts. Then Griffin left the game due to an ankle injury as he was trying to beat out a bunt that he laid down in his at-bat, in his coming up at-bat. And hopefully he'll be all right. There's a swing and a miss. And that is out number two. Now batting number two, Brandon Scrady. Here is Brandon Scrady, the second baseman. Two away, and runner still sitting down there in Peterson at first base. That's fouled back towards us. Oh, one now. There's a pretty good looking curveball for a strike, and it's 0-2. Larson comes in with a fastball. That's fouled off. And we'll keep it there with two down. Scrady trying to come up with a base hit. Man, he's really got to be defensive here. Down 0-2. Missed low and away. Thanks to Rural Mutual Insurance, Kevin Blusky Agency. And, hey, we want to say congrats to Kevin. Looks like, sounds like he's going to be taking that retirement route somewhere down the road here in the not-too-distant future. We certainly appreciate all of Kevin's help over the years. That one hops. Nice hustle there by Hoven. Keeping the runner at first. And now you take a look at the count. It's 2-2. And actually, it's 3-2, says the umpire. Oh, Larson trying to come in, and he just had that ball get away from him. Scrady is hit by the pitch. And we are going to the top of the order here with two on. And now a timeout after that pitch. Top of the order now with Tyden Lynn. Going to take a called strike. Coming right down the middle. 6-3 ground out and got caught looking back in the second. His first two appearances here. Fouls that one back, and now he's in the hole. 0-2. And a called strike three. Larson painted the outside part of the plate to get that third out. Well, let's take a look. No runs on no hits. There was an error in the inning. A hit batsman. Two left on. We go to the bottom of the fourth. 2-1 score, Viroqua. Stepping in for the Westby Coon Valley Bandits. Here in the bottom of the fourth inning, they trail 2-1. Jaden Johnson, Micah Larson to follow. And then Anders Hoven, your first three batters. That one's just fouled off. Kowalczyk will retrieve that one. Half hour lightning delay. This ball has popped up, and second baseman able to make that grab. That was Scrady over there. Here's the pitcher and Micah Larson following that pop-up from Johnson. With one away, Larson stepping in from the right side once again, takes a called strike. Oh for one here today. Here's a fly ball, and it is right out to Alex Klum in center field.
Next batter, number six.
Klum moves out to center field as Tyler Bast now pitching. Tanner Bast, excuse me, not Tyler, Tanner. And there's two down. Good. Hoven fouls that one off to the left side. Well out of play. One the offering on the way. It's inside 2-1. Bast is set. Here he comes. That's in tight again. Thanks to Scenic Bluffs Community Healthcare bringing you today's action. Appreciate their terrific support, as well as the Miranda Wright Agency. Yeah! Here's a base hit to the right side. That's American Family Insurance, Westby, and Viroqua. Miranda Wright. Well, there was a nice hit by Anders Hoven coming up with the single. He is sitting down there at first base now.
Come on,
and it's going to bring up the number 9 hitter in Hadley Brown. Maddox Torkelson on deck, the number 10 hitter. The Bandits batting 10, Viroqua batting a DH. Again, 2-1 the score here with the 138ers out in front. Bottom of the fourth inning. Here's a shot. And that's going to drop in for a base hit out to left field. Man, that brings up Torkelson.
Number 14, Maddox Torkelson.
Two down, two on. Tying run down there at second base for the Bandits. Torkelson looking to see what he can do here with Tanner Bast. He fouls that one off to the right side here, heading to the car area. I think it missed him. Bast jumps into the lead here at 0-1. Now it's 0-2. Curveball that dropped right on the knees. Here's a ground ball. That's going to go right back up the middle. And they are sending him. Here comes the throw. It is in time. Yes. Boy, what a throw there from Alex Klum in center field. That takes care of the inning. A base hit. And runner is thrown out. 8-2. That means no runs on 3 hits, 2 runners left on. We'll take a break. It is still 2-1. We go to the fifth, Viroqua. We are moving into the top half of inning number 5, and Finn Thiebold is going to step in. Thanks going out to Coon Valley Telecommunications bringing you the action today from Central Avenue there in Coon Valley. Cash and Farm Supply, your organic farming experts on Highway 27. And Cash and Building Supply, CBS Design, helping us out. Downtown Cashton. Well, called strike to even the count, and it's now 2-1. After 3 pitches. Theobald today, 1-for-2. Called strike. Now 2-2. Pop this one up and out of play. A Swing and a foul tip hung on by Anders Hoven for the strikeout.
Now batting number 16, Ryan.
One away, here's your number three hitter in Ryan Kowalczyk. Kowalczyk is going to get double duty tonight. He's going to be the starting catcher for the senior 138ers as he's catching here tonight as well. Carmen Fortune helping us out, your new directions real estate expert, bringing you today's ball game. And Bethel Home and Services supporting our broadcast. We thank all these sponsors. We continue on. We got a couple more to talk about before we close the deal here today. Here's a shot. That's going to be a base hit. Out to right center and a nice swing.
Next batter, number seven, Alex Klum.
Here's Klum, who had a terrific throw to get out number three at home just moments ago. Looked like it was going to be a tie ball game, and Klum came up firing. To get the runner, cut him down at home. That's going to be low and away. This is Jaden Johnson now pitching, if I forgot to mention that. Comes in a little bit high. That one nearly got him. Three and oh now with one out. A little toss back over to first base and diving back in. Runner taking off, there's a called strike to throw down, and he just got in. Pretty close play, but the hand got in there, says the umpire. And it's 3-1. There's a base hit to right field, and they're going to hold the runner now as the throw comes in. Knocked down by Hoven. Good job there as the ball was on the third base side and about 10, 12 feet above home plate.
Next batter, number three, Tanner Bass.
So the single, and the runners at first and third for Tanner Bass, who's now pitching. Well, the Senior Legion game was scheduled to start at 7:30. That's what time we have right now. Whether this is the last inning or they'll play all seven, it's hard to say. We'll find that out in a little bit. Called strike, catching the outside part of the plate. Little toss back over just to keep the runner at first wide awake. Showing bunt, and he offered. Going clear across home plate. Oh, 2 the count to Tanner Bass. Fouled that one off. Stay on him, Jay. Colton Peterson on deck. Another little soft toss over to first base. That'll be high. One and two now. Here's a ground ball. Dropped it. They'll not get the out as Fensel dropped the ball on top of the throw. So there's an error, and the run will score. You could almost go with two errors. When you think about both of them dropped it, that's the part that will drive a coach crazy. Bast at first base, down at second is Klum. And Peterson up to bat here. He'll take the pitch outside. Here goes a throw. They're going to get him down at third. Well, pretty good throw by Hoven on that one. He was spot on. It is 2-5 on the putout. Two down. Here's a high fly ball coming up and making the running catch here for out number three off from the bat of Peterson. Well, the 138ers will pick up a run. They get that run on a couple of hits. There are a couple of errors in the inning as well here on the Bandits of Westby Coon Valley. It is now a 3-1 score here in favor of Viroqua. Here's Landon's off, and the first pitch is going to be out in front of home plate. Well, a hard stop, they call it here, at 7:45. See how things are going. But this is likely going to be the last at-bat in the ball game. Swing and a miss. Senior team to follow this. They won't start until well after 8 o'clock now. But, you know, not a whole lot going on. It's a great night. It is dead still with the wind, though. There is no breeze. Now 2-1. Now 2-2. Landon Lee up to bat. Missed just outside. Landon was the one who made the third out or got the catch out in left field for out number three. Come running in for that grab. Here's a ball lifted up in the air. First baseman is going to have that one in Hoyam. And there's one down. Here's Maddox Fensel now. One for one here. He walked back in the first inning and came up with a base hit with an 0-2 count right back up the middle in the third. There's a strike, 1-1. A little bit high and outside, it's 2-1. 3-1 the score. There's a called strike. And there is a called strike three. Not able to pull the trigger on that one. And there are two down here. Here's Everett Hoven now. Everett today 0 for 1 with a walk and a strikeout. Curveball starting him off. Our thanks going out to the Aging and Disability Resource Center of Vernon County, bringing you the action today. And, of course, final one, the Bank of Cashton, Scott Wall and that crew in downtown Cashton. And, of course, you see those sponsors in the lower left corner of the screen throughout the ball game. 2-1 now. He got the call on the curve. Now 2-2. Foul ball and hung on to end the inning. And that should take care of this ball game, I would certainly think here at 7:41. Well, if they're going to do the hard stop, we'll wait and see. All right, here they go. Not a hard stop because it's 7:44. And they're going to start an inning here. So we'll play a little longer. We're in the sixth. A fly ball center field. Hoyam is out number one on the fly ball. Here's Tyler Burris, the DH today, DHing for Jaden Burkhart. First pitch is low and away. Here's a two-hopper picked up. Fensel, the throw. On the money, and there's two down. 6-3 on the putout. Now it's up to Brandon Screedy, who was hit by the pitch in his last at-bat. Swing and a miss. Stay tuned following this one as The Senior Legion team will play. Curveball outside. It's 1-1. Fly ball. Lee coming over. That's going to drop in for a base hit. Not able to get to that one, and Scrady puts it on the line for a single. Here is Titan Lynn stepping back in, the leadoff man who's 0 for 3. Couple of strikeouts on third called strike. Twice that happened to him. Getting fooled. And then a ground out 6-3 in his first at bat. Well, he's due here. This one's popped up and out of play. Over here, not too far from us. Wow. Toss over to first, and back in is Screedy. Curveball, fly ball, and it is going to be caught by Fensel for out number 3 on the pop-up. Well, it looks like we will go to bat here in the bottom of the sixth. We'll be back. It's 3-1 Viroqua. Jeremy Hayes is going to step in to start things off in the bottom of the sixth inning, which looks to be the last inning. As the senior team getting ready to take the field and warm up. So it'll probably be close to a 8:30 start or thereabouts. Especially if they take the infield and everything. 3-0 now. Four, five, six, part of the order. Hayes is walked.
Now batting number 5, Chase Quellhorst.
So one on for Chase Quellhorst. And we're going to get a courtesy runner to come out for Hayes. Quellhorst today is 0 for 2. Takes the ball in very tight. Nearly catching him on the knees. Next at bat is just outside. It's 2-0. There's a strike. Two, one to count. Bass kicks and fires. It's fouled back. Now 2-2. With a runner on. Nobody out here as Viroqua leads 3-1 with 8 hits and 1 error on their ledger. That ball is going to kick away, but not far enough away from anybody. The pinch runner will stay put. We got a full count now. Quick toss and back in. Quellhorst, again, as I mentioned, looking for his first base hit of the ball game. That's going to be a walk. Two walks in a row here. And that means we're going to get a visit on the mound here with the coach. Well, the conference on the mound now complete, and stepping in is Jaden Johnson. Shows bunt. This is popped up, and a great try. It's going to be, it was touched. Oh, it's going to be a base hit. That was a wonderful try by Kowalczyk, diving forward, and then the ball popping out of his glove there with that wicked spin. But I think we're going to have to go with a base hit. That was a great effort. Bases loaded, nobody out here for Micah Larson. Swinging a foul tip. Oh, 1-1 now. Winning run over at first base. That's low. Good job knocking that one down. One, one the count. Here's a ball foul down the third base side. Boy, he tried to paint the line. Just missed on that one. Did Larson. Nobody away and bases filled with Bandits here. The offering rode up high on the shoulder for a ball. 2-2. The kick and swing, it's a foul ball. Well, he was pretty much on it, just a little bit under. And we'll keep it at 2-2. That's in the dirt. And the count is now full at 3-2. This one's popped up. It'll be an infield fly rule. And there's one down.
Next batter, number six, Anders Hoven.
Here's Anders Hoven now. With one out. Anders today 1-for-1 with a walk. Here's a ball sliced to the left side, and two runs are going to score. And all of a sudden, it's tied up at 3 apiece. Hoven sliced that one to the left side. Here's Hadley Brown with runners at first and second, two away.
Come on, Hadley!
Swing and a miss, the ball getting away, and runners will move up a spot. Down at third is Johnson. Anders sitting at second base. Anders doesn't matter right now. He can stay put. It's the runner at third that you want in. That'll be outside. The offering came in tight, and it's 2-1 with one out. Called strike. 2-2 now. Here's the 2-2 offering, and it's a swing and a foul tip hung on by Qualcheck, and there's two away. Here's Maddox Torkelson now with two down. Torkelson, 1-for-2 today. There's a curveball starting them out for a strike. And another one. That one inside and then dropped across the middle of the plate at the knees. 0-2 to Torkelson. Looking to try and get a base hit with two strikes on him. Oh, they got him on a called strike 3. Well, it's 3-3 now. And that is going to be the ball game. They're going to leave it as a tie here, and the senior team can get warmed up and get going here, hopefully, before 8:30 or right around that time frame. 3-3 is your final score here as the Bandits come back and score a couple runs in the bottom of the sixth inning for the tie. We hope you've enjoyed watching this Western Wisconsin video production of Westby Coon Valley Bandit and Viroqua 138er baseball action. Stay tuned. More coming up here as the seniors will tangle here in about 20 minutes or so.